Time now for Morning Rounds, our look at the medical news of the week. We begin with a problem that often precedes a stroke. Around 15% of stroke victims first experience transient ischemic attacks, or TIAs. A survey published this week by the American Heart and Stroke Association found that about 1 in 3 Americans have had symptoms of such attacks.
TIAs are often referred to as minor or mini strokes. According to the American Stroke Association, they occur when a blood clot blocks an artery for a short time. The symptoms are the same as a stroke, but usually only last for a few minutes. CBS News contributor Dr. Tara Narula is here to tell us more. Tara, what exactly are these symptoms, which, as we said, are similar to a full stroke?
Yeah, recognizing these symptoms is really the key to being able to act quickly. And so things that people can remember: if you feel sudden or unexpected numbness or tingling or weakness on one side of your body, trouble with your vision, trouble speaking or understanding language, difficulty walking, feeling off balance or dizzy, or even a sudden severe unexpected headache, those should trigger you to take action. One quick mnemonic that the American Stroke Association likes to use is FAST. The F stands for face drooping, the A stands for arm weakness, the S stands for speech difficulty, and the T stands for time to call 911. Now, the issue with these mini strokes is that they are actually a blessing in disguise in that they are warning strokes. 1/3 of people with TIAs will go on to have a severe real stroke within the next year or so, and usually even within 90 days. So really important to pay attention.
Tara, as it regards the survey, when people did exhibit symptoms, what did they usually do in response?
So they didn't do what they were supposed to do. In this survey, they looked at about 2,000 individuals, and 35% of them experienced one of these symptoms of a TIA. About 20 to 40% of them chose to wait until the symptoms went away. About 30 to 50% rested, and about another 18 to 60% took some form of medication. And interestingly, only 3% called 911. And again, it's really important to go to the ER so that you can have imaging done to determine, is it a TIA, is it a stroke, to look at what your risk factors are and to make a plan for prevention, what kind of testing you need and what kind of medication potentially.
Don't ignore it.
Please don't ignore it.
Okay, up next, one of the most pervasive health conditions in America, asthma. May is Asthma and Allergy Awareness Month, according to the CDC. In 2015, over 18 million adults and 6 million children had asthma. That equates to almost 8% of the population. Tara, an asthma attack can be really scary. What are some of the symptoms that people should be aware of?
For anyone who's ever had it, it is one of the most horrible things to feel like you can't breathe.
Yeah.
And so a description that I read that I really liked is, imagine trying to breathe through a straw that's plugged up with cotton. Yeah. That's what's happening to the airways. They're becoming inflamed, constricted, tightened. Mucus can fill them, and it's very difficult to breathe. So people can feel short of breath, they can cough, they can hear wheezing, and they can have chest tightness or chest pain. The nice thing about asthma is that although it is a chronic disease, it is controllable for most people by taking medications, by understanding your triggers.
It can't be cured, but preparation can help. What sort of preparation?
Preparation is really key for this chronic disease. And so what we like patients to do is to develop a personalized written action plan with their doctor. And this really highlights several things. It highlights their particular triggers and how to avoid them, how and when to take their asthma medications, how to recognize their symptoms and when their symptoms might be getting worse, and then importantly, what action to take when they do get worse, when to call the doctor, when to go to the ER. They use typically a nice, easy format like a traffic signal, green, yellow, and red, that people can understand. These action plans should be updated once a year, and for kids, important to give that to their caregivers, all their caregivers, so they know how to respond.
We talk about the personal impact, but there's also the societal impact. I think a lot of people don't understand the financial impact that asthma is having on the U.S.
Very expensive for our country. It costs about $56 billion a year in this country to deal with asthma. About $50 billion worth is the hospitalizations or stays. And then there are the indirect costs of missed days of school and work, about 10 million missed days of school for kids and 14 million missed days of work for adults.
Wow, that's a lot. Finally, time for our segment, Practical Advice. This week, when to take action when having chest pain. Tara, for example, sometimes it can be hard to tell the difference between chest pain that could just be heartburn and something more serious like a heart attack.
It can, and unfortunately, this is why a lot of people ignore it. They feel chest pain, they take Tums, they say, oh, you know, it went away, it's not a big deal. But the thing I like to tell my patients is that while chest pain can come from different causes, so stomach ulcers, acid reflux, musculoskeletal concerns, lung issues, the one you want to worry about, the one that you need to act quickly on, is the chest pain that comes from the heart. And you need to rule that out before you ascribe it to something else. Because when the heart muscle cells die, they cannot be regenerated. And so with cardiac chest pain, you need to act quickly. We have great treatments. We have great ability to help people, but you got to get to the hospital fast. So people should remember, if they feel a pressure, heaviness in the chest that may be associated with breaking out into a cold sweat, nausea, shortness of breath, pain that's in the jaw or the neck, these are things that should prompt them to get to the ER. And they should do it by calling EMS, not by getting themselves in a car, right, because the EMS can really treat them right away. They'll get them expedited once they get to the hospital. And if their heart stops from an arrhythmia or some problem, electrical problem, they have defibrillators they can use. So please, every 40 seconds, an American has a heart attack. I mean, in the time we've done this segment, about six people or seven have had a heart attack. Really important to pay attention.
Wise words, Dr. Tara Narula. Thanks, as always. Thank you.